Good afternoon, 47. Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries' new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get.
This will be over in no time. Thank you.
Let me just repeat some ground rules for those of you new. When the time's up, we have our winner.
See that red car, 47? That's the Kronstadt race car with Sierra Knox behind the wheel.
Oh, and let me just repeat some ground rules for those of you new to the
dirt. I don't care about these projects, all right? I made it clear this morning that if things didn't change, I'd be off the Kronstadt team. Half an hour later, I have to listen to Knox berate my skills as a mechanic because the roll cage interferes with the radio signals from Sierra's suit.
No more.
I'm done. Yes, I know you're a man short now, and no, I don't give a rat's ass about it. Tell you
yes.
Double my salary for the entire week, and I'll come back in case Sierra decides to use that last pit stop.
There is still plenty of time
to otherwise. I'll be down by the
endurance race. It's all about getting your car to cover as many miles as possible, no matter how turned out or beat up it may be. It's a test of nerves going into that corner. Backs down first. Oh, wait. Was there a touch? Was there a slight collision going into that corner? Oh, the stewards might have to be close to let me just repeat some ground rules for those of you new to the new. Time's up. We have our winner.
That's okay.
It's just so mean.
Hey, don't get any oil on my clothes.
Ah, fix them up good, huh?
So that's Bruno Diaz, came in third last year on this track. He'd want to do better this time around, and I wouldn't be too surprised to see him on the podium at the end of the day.
Thank you. John, it's Grace. Look, I'm in a deep hole. One of my guys just jumped ship and I need a replacement ASAP. Are you available? Shit. All right, gotta run. Talk later.
So, who is this guy, anyway? Anyone know him?
You're starting to piss me off.
Man.
You're the junior slip wrench who got injured yesterday, right?
Suppose I am.
Great, this is your lucky day. Do well and there's a bonus in it, got it?
Got it.
All right, everyone, look alive and get to your stations. Sierra may come in for a last-minute pit stop, and I need you ready and able. You, rookie, get into position. Grab your preferred tool and be prepared. Today's your day to shine. Let's do this. Coming in. Everyone on your stations, now!
Target down. Next up, Robert Nooks.
Listen up, we got a situation here.
What's going on here? What happened?
There's this creep walking around. I told him to leave, but he said nothing.
Good job, thank you.
Ronstadt Industries wishes you and your family.
hope it's not like last year with a streak.
I'll pick the celebrations.
Keep your clothes on, folks. Please.
Hello?
That we're closer to the ceremony, but not quite there yet. Just saw the actor Jamie St. Remington in the press room, by the way. Those of you older race fans might remember him from such films as Rush in Reno and Daytona Drivers Club. Yeah, they don't make them like that.
An abandoned apricot.
That is Robert Knox, genius inventor, black markets weapons dealer, and Providence defector.
This is a restricted area.
Nice and slow. Yeah, I got you now. I just want to make sure you're not going to do anything.
Hands high, elbows low. Move your head. Take him down.
Money is not the issue.
Thank you.
mechanics talking about it the other day. Something about not wanting to use this, wanting to win on our own.
Imagine that. Isn't that illegal? I understood the reason here. Just fucking rabbit or something happens to it. No fucking rabbit. Doc
is a genuine technical genius. He's really protective about his projects. Prefers to fix everything himself, apparently.
Don't worry about grabbing him. If anything goes awry, you'll see him down here as fast as lightning.
Gotcha.
Robert Knox has a race car on display in the expo building. The show staff is under strict instructions to summon him at any sign of malfunction. Apparently, Knox trusts no one to fix his car but him. Perhaps it's time to poke around under the hood, 47. They do say one should never mess with another man's wheels.
Good to see you, sir.
Good. I dare say this should get Knox's undivided attention.
Huh. Why's the engine on?
Let's just try to get this started again.
Heads will roll. That fixed it.
How are we doing? Talk to me, people.
Move it! I think we're clear here, sir!
Hey, mister, don't turn your back on me.
Hey, sir!
Whoa, dude!
Oh, Jesus!
Have you come to this man with me?
What's our status? Are we clear? Johnson, I need the threat assessment evaluation right now.
Compromise. Down the
bridge. I think it's safe to move on now. Oh, Jesus Christ, I'm in!
Oh, God!
Both Help! Targets down. Please, well done, 47. Me. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Berlin. Shanghai. Montreal. We're bleeding operatives. Panic is spreading, and now we are axing our own?
Knox was a traitor. He would have caused incalculable damage.
And he won't be the last. This is exactly what the enemy wants. We need to fight the sickness, not the symptom.
And I have just the tool for the job.
Right. The Burnwood woman. Eric Soders warned you about her, didn't he? The Crusader.
I can handle Miss Burnwood. Everyone hates power until you offer them some.
You ought to know.
ICA speaks the enemy's language. We need them.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadowboxing. We need to know who we are up against.
I was getting to that. His name is Lucas Gray, the late Mr. Cobb's head of security. Cobb was ground zero, first of our operatives to die. It had to be one of his staff, someone with military training and access to the plane.
Grasping at straws.
Gray is a mercenary, a veteran of every backwater tragedy you've ever ignored on the 5 o'clock news. Chechnya, Sierra Leone, the list goes on, but before 89, nothing. No records of any kind.
Ah, come on. CIA, KGB, plenty of spies went dark.
After the curtain was lifted, I cast a very wide net. Lucas Gray simply does not exist.
If you're all quite done wetting yourselves with excitement, I couldn't give two shits where he came from. I only want to know one thing.
How does he know about us?
I swear to God, this hearts and flowers crap will get us both killed. Can't you see? Your so-called friend is working for them now. He's not the man you knew.
This is his fight too, Olivia.
Even if he doesn't realize it. Like it or not, 47 is our last and only lead on the partners. He needs to remember.
He's coming for us. And unlike you, he won't hesitate.
Just get me inside. Rico, I need a favor.